such an enormous thrill for the Glee Club of Princeton University to be back in this wonderful, wonderful hall. It's the first time in 4 years. It's been way too long, but for those very few of us, it's just me and just one or two grad students on the stage who've experienced singing in this hall before, and it comes flooding back just how special it is. And for everybody else who's singing here for the first time, what a wonderful treat. But far more powerful a feeling right now is the joy of being back in the same room as our dear friends from the Harvard Glee Club and their wonderful director, Andy Clark. We've already shown us so much warmth today to more than make up for all that's been missing over the last 4 years. It's really wonderful to see you all again. Thank you so much for looking after us so well, for feeding us so well today. Absolutely fantastic. We can't wait to hear you sing. We get our show started today with a little group of pieces which is revolves around the theme of self-identity and self-actualization. We began there with a little Bach chorale, Ich bin ja Herr in deiner Macht, I stand in your power, O God, and followed that with a setting of Ich bin das Brot des Lebens, I am the bread of life, by the contemporary German composer Wolfram Buchenberg. Beautiful piece. And on the same theme, but in a very, very different direction now, we're going to sing a lovely song by Majel Connery. Majel was a student at Princeton. She was a member of the Glee Club class of 2001. She's now a fantastic singer-songwriter, and she wrote a set of pieces called The Rivers Are Our Brothers this year, and she wrote it for the storied American vocal ensemble Chanticleer. Chanticleer came to campus a couple of weeks ago and did a concert with us in our own hall, Richardson Auditorium, and we performed a couple of these songs with Chanticleer, and we have a kind of version of one of those songs which we're going to sing for you now. It's called I Am a Rock. So this cycle, The Rivers Are Our Brothers, it is a kind of whimsical take on the theme of ecology, and the poet asks us, the poet is the songwriter, Majel Connery, she asks us to imagine what life is like, or what existence is like, for various elements of nature. And so these songs have titles like I Am Snow, I Am a River, I Am a Mountain, I Am a Cloud. And so this is just one of those songs. It's called I Am a Rock.
Thank you.
gorgeous double choir motet from Johannes Brahms there, Unsere Väter, Hoffen auf dich. Something completely different now, something completely different, deliberately different. This is a pop song from 2011 by the English rock band Everything Everything. And it was written in the summer of 2011, which was a summer of great, particularly urban discontent in the United Kingdom. There were lots of riots in the summer, in the late summer of that year, across many cities in the United Kingdom. And this band, Everything Everything, they responded to this feeling of civil unrest in the United Kingdom with this song. And it's really about it's about the spell which we are all cast under by greed. The lead singer of the band, his name is Jonathan Higgs. He describes the song as representing when you wake up and realize how unfair the world is, but then feel yourself slipping back into the spell of greed. And so it's a kind of embarrassed confessional, which explains why the title, the unusual title, is Cough, Cough.
Cough, cough, yeah, cough, cough, so cough, cough, I'm cough, cough, wait a second, cough, cough, yeah, cough, cough, so cough, cough, I'm cough, cough,
Okay, next up, we're going to sing a couple of movements from Francis Poulenc's cantata Figure Humaine. This epic piece of choral music, Figure Humaine, was composed during the Second World War, and it is really a kind of emblem of a particular French kind of resistance to tyranny. And this this resistance is expressed through the surrealist poetry of Paul Éluard, which was a very, very important galvanizing artistic force for the French during the Second World War under Nazi occupation. This is the Princeton University Chamber Choir, or part of it. We are working on this piece at the moment for a performance at the National Collegiate Choral Organizations Conference in a few weeks' time, where we're going to be singing the whole piece. It is, it's an epic learn and an epic sing, and it's very important that that we absorb it in bite-sized chunks and perform it. So part of what we're doing tonight is getting more and more comfortable with this extraordinary difficult piece, but also it's stunning and absolutely beautiful, and I hope you enjoy these two short movements. The piece represents a kind of swing between optimism and despair, which was clearly felt at the time. This is 1943, this sense of progress and then this sense of defeat. And you can certainly feel in these two movements, the first of them has a kind of calm presence to it, a sense that all will be well, toi ma patiente. And then the second of them is an extraordinarily desolate and lonely expression. In the poetry, we find the poet lost and alone and terrified in the woods. And in a solo which is expressed in the upper soprano part. So I do hope you enjoy these two movements from Poulenc's Figure Humaine.
Oh.
our final two pieces in our set, the opening half of this concert. They might make apparent strange bedfellows, but they're very closely connected in their theme. This idea of the release of the burden of life and the joy of acceding to the afterlife, this sense of optimism for what lies beyond mortality. Selig sind die Toten by Heinrich Schütz, that wonderful late Renaissance motet we've just sung, Blessed Are the Dead, a text also very familiar from those of you, for those of you who love the Ein Deutsches Requiem of Johannes Brahms. It has much in common with the text of our final piece, which is the American spiritual The Set Down Servant. Again, it is an overt, an apparent expression of joy, but it's very clear, in fact, that the joy is anticipatory, that it is not being felt here on earth, but it is being anticipated in the life beyond. For us in the Glee Club, one of our big learning and performance projects this year is going to be a long collaboration with the American Spiritual Ensemble, a wonderful American choir directed by Dr. Everett McCorvey. And they're going to be visiting Princeton's campus in February next year and teaching us and working with us, and then at the end of which we'll be giving a concert with them. But as a kind of precursor to that process, as a first stage in that learning process, we were privileged this week to work with the composer and arranger Stacey Gibbs, came to visit us on Wednesday and taught us the piece which we're going to sing for you now. So we're at the very beginning of this learning process. Our experience with Stacey on Wednesday was truly, truly revelatory, and I fear that the job of synthesizing everything that he taught us and then trying to kind of make it work as a conductor, I'm not sure that I'm really going to succeed in giving everything that he taught us, but I will do my best. It is the most fantastic arrangement of a well-known spiritual, Stacey Gibbs' arrangement of Set Down Servant.
Soul have I, soul have I.
So if there are any former members of this choir who are in the room today, come up and see us. And I'd like to welcome to the podium the president of the Princeton University Glee Club, Sydney Eck. Come on, Sydney.
Thank you so much. Thank you for being with us this evening, and of course, most special thanks to the wonderful Princeton Glee Club. Just a dazzling offering of music tonight. So beautifully sung, so eclectic, so interesting. And as always, just great to share this experience with you. And as Gabriel said, welcome you back to Sanders Theater after 4 years. The highlight of the Harvard Glee Club's season is a 3.5-week tour that we will take in the winter break to Europe. We're going to leave 2 days after Christmas on a trip that will take us to England, France, Italy, Germany, and Portugal. The tour is actually marking the 100th anniversary of the group's very first international tour, a couple years late. In 1921, the Harvard Glee Club was invited by the French government to travel across the Atlantic on a steamship just a few years after a global pandemic. It was there that they met Poulenc, as well as Darius Milhaud, Gustav Holst, Camille Saint-Saëns, and a host of other luminaries at the time, legends now. And on our trip, we are going to not only explore and invoke the music of that journey over 100 years ago, but to also have an opportunity to bring some American music to our European audiences and to have some great learning experiences while we are on the continent, as they say. So I don't have a lot to share tonight other than this. We're going to take you on a little bit of a pre-tour travelogue through some of these countries. We'll start with England. A lot of choirs around the world, including Princeton's own chamber chorus. Many, many others have been marking the 400th anniversary of the death of the great English composer William Byrd, who died on July 4th, 1623. We'll start by singing two movements from his Mass for three voices. After that, we're going to move to the French Romantic era in the music of Gabriel Fauré in a setting for tenor bass voices of his well-known Cantique of Jean Racine. Then I'm going to invite my brand new colleague, Benjamin Perry, to the podium to conduct that piece as well as some pieces that were a favorite of the Harvard Glee Clubs in the 1970s from the Alpini tradition in the Alps in northern Italy. When we're around Milan in January, we're going to have a chance to learn from some culture and tradition bearers of a very idiosyncratic and wonderfully vibrant men's choral tradition called the Alpini tradition, of which a few Italian mountain songs that we'll share with you tonight are derived. And after an offering from Harvard Glee Club Light, we'll bring it back here to the United States and present two works from Atlanta, Georgia, that represent, I think, any time an American choir travels overseas, it's really important for us to share what is the greatest contribution America has made to the world of choral music, which is black music. And we have spent some time over the last 3 years connecting with the wonderful choirs of historically black colleges and universities, including the Morehouse Glee Club, directed by David Morrow now for several decades. We'll be singing a piece the Glee Club has loved for a long time called Got a Mind to Do Right. After we sing the East Coast premiere of a Christmas motet, O Manu Mysterium, by a graduate of Spelman, a former member of their Glee Club, now a faculty member at Georgia Tech, B.E. Boykin. So that's the music we have to share with you. and we hope you enjoy our set. And thanks again for being with us on this warm and beautiful homecoming and family weekend.
Thank you.
have neglected to share one important bit of information that on the next piece will be joined by the manager of this 3.5-week tour, who has been planning this trip for several years now. Also found out this week that he's a terrific violinist. Max Immigrant is going to be playing on the...
I have the privilege of directing Harvard Glee Club Light. A little larger than you might remember, but inflation's been tough this past year.
Icy outdoor pool. When you jumped in first, I went in too. I'm with you even if it makes me blue. Which takes me back to the color that we painted your brother's wall. Honey, with like all the X's, bites, and flaws, we wouldn't be standing here so tall. Kiss you once, cause I know you had a long night. Kiss you twice, cause it's gonna be alright. Three times, cause I've waited my whole life. I like shiny things, but I'd marry you with paper rings, uh-huh. That's right, darling, you're the one I want. And I hate accidents, except when we went from friends to this, uh-huh. That's right, darling, you're the one I want. In paper rings, in picture frames, in dirty dreams, whoa, you're the one I want. I want to drive away with you. I want your complications too. I want your dreary Mondays. Wrap your arms around me, baby boy. I want to drive away with you. I want to drive away with you. I want your dreary Mondays. Wrap your arms around me, baby boy. You're the one I want. I like shiny things. I'd marry you with paper rings.
Yes, sir.
That's right. Darling, you're the one I want. And I made accidents except when we went from friends to this.
Yes, sir.
That's right. Darling, you're the one I want in paper rings. In picture frames. In dirty dreams. Whoa. You're the one I want. You're the one I want.
too. What a fun audience we have tonight. I am so happy to see you all here. On behalf of the Harvard Glee Club, we are so honored to welcome you here tonight in historic Sanders Theater for the 108th Harvard-Princeton football concert. Can you imagine we've been doing this for 108 times? Wow. And this is our fourth year back since the pandemic. From the bottom of our hearts, we are so grateful for each and one of you here tonight. Friends, family, alumni, and our rivals for the evening, our compatriots from Princeton. No, they're just our best friends. I can't dwell on that for too long because I think they whooped us pretty bad last week. My name is Andrew Liu. I am a senior in Leverett House, and I am the president of the Harvard Glee Club. The next song we'll be singing for you tonight is called Glorious Apollo, and it is a glee. It's actually the only glee we sing, even though we're called the Harvard Glee Club. So what is this glee that we and our friends up there have dedicated our namesakes to? Well, a glee is an 18th century English part song, usually sung at dinner clubs. So if you imagine a bunch of pals wearing nice clothes like we are tonight, eating, drinking, talking, and most importantly, singing, usually with a libation in hand, or a few. I actually saw a Crimson article from 1921 this past week that came from a student complaining about how the Glee Club doesn't sing glees anymore. Well, we're about to give you one. And why has this been the only Glee Club to last this long in our 166-year history? Well, it's because it espouses our four cardinal virtues of glee, good humor, unity, and joy. On my left, I have a smaller choir composed of graduating members of the Glee Club who will be leading the larger choir on the right in our celebration of these virtues. We thank you so much for coming again, and we hope you enjoy the rest of our concert tonight. singing our football songs next. So if we have any alumni in the crowd, anyone in the Harvard community. Am I hearing something? Yes, Aaron.
Tigers.
Tiger? Where? The Tiger's fixed?
Ladies and gentlemen, I believe earlier tonight you may have witnessed a little bit of a tussle for a certain Tiger that belongs to the Princeton Glee Club. We saw that he had a little bit of injuries, so we took it upon ourselves to bring it to the best healthcare on campus, Harvard University Health Services. And worry not, he is back in tip-top shape. And oh, there comes our doctor right now. He's all fixed up by Harvard. Look at him, brand spanking new.
God, I love pre-med.
Please enjoy the football songs.
Thousand men of Harvard on victory tree.
like to conclude the concert by inviting our friends from Princeton back to the stage for the Princeton and Harvard alma mater.
Thank you. I would like to offer a peace offering to our good friends from Princeton.
Of evening, we'll be singing Fair Harvard. I would like to ask the audience to stand as you are able to.
We wish you a wonderful evening, a parents' weekend, and a Hallow weekend.